These are very, very difficult times, and the pandemic has taught us to reinvent and pivot what we already know. And that's what we have done with the Shalma Pujas. These are a series of online Shalma Pujas or virtual Shalma Pujas, and the artists have dedicated themselves to improve, perform, perfect, and practice whatever they learned in our class. I'm so glad that you'll be joining us today, and I really hope you enjoy the Shalma Pujas as much as we enjoy putting them together. And through all the hard work and toil, there is the ultimate joy of dancing. And I hope you're able to join us and engage with us on this wonderful, wonderful journey. The times are tough, but that does not prevent us from relearning, rethinking, and trying to go ahead with life. Thank you so much for being there with us. And I hope you encourage these wonderful artists, these very wonderful budding artists, and I hope they continue on their journey as well and not stop. Thank you so much.
Hello. Let me start today by introducing our beloved Guru, Srimati Mridula Arend. She is the disciple of renowned Bharatanatyam exponent, Padmashri Sudha Vandilakupati. She has performed in many places in India under the auspices of renowned banners. She has performed in all the major dance festivals in Chennai and in other parts of India and was awarded the Award of Excellence in 2000 by Shri Parthasarathi Swami Sabha as part of its centenary celebrations. She was also awarded the title Bharata Kala Bhushana during the 32nd anniversary celebrations of Shri Bharatalaya titled Natya Devu Baba. She also received the prestigious Yuva Kala Bharati. She was the cultural chairperson at the Sri Venkateshwara Temple, Pittsburgh, USA, for the year 2006-2007, one of the most well-recognized and the largest temples in the US. Sri Venkateshwara Temple has always had a special regard for cultural and religious activities. She has helped organize concerts by leading artists from India and the USA in Pittsburgh and is always keen on bridging the gap between performers and rasikas. She has innovated in the introduction of adapting compositions to dance. For the first time, to the Tyagaraja, Alvar, Purandaradasa, Annamacharya Aradhanas held yearly with great fanfare at the Sri Venkateshwara Temple. Mirroring her interest in dance, ma'am is also interested in research involving basic science, which prompted her to obtain her undergraduate degree in biochemistry and graduate degree in zoology from the University of Madras, Chennai. She then went ahead to complete a master's in molecular biology at Stanford University, USA in 2005 and moved to Pittsburgh, where she continued her research work. She is currently an innovation and IP researcher with a law degree at ISB Hyderabad. I think she is perfect in being the living example of talent, diversity and versatility.
Thank you.
today. Anupama has been very passionate about dance, especially Bharatanatyam since her childhood. She never got an opportunity though to learn dance. Later, education, job, marriage and children kept her busy, but she never gave up on her dream. When she turned 35, she decided to relentlessly pursue her dream and found her guru in Srimati Mrigala Anand. Her guru is instrumental in encouraging her to push her limits and also to reiterate the fact that age is just a number when it came to dance. Under her guru's guidance, Anupama is now ready for her Shalangya Puja and she believes that this is just the beginning.
Takka dimmi, takka junnu, takka dimmi, takka junnu.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwarah, Guru Saksha Parat Brahma, Tasme Shri Gurave Namaha, Jnanandam Mayam Devam, Nirmalaspatikakritam, Adharam Sarva Vidyanam, Hayagrivam Upasmahe.
Swati Namastobhyam, Parate Kamarupini, Vidyarambham Karishyami, Siddhir Bhavitu Me Sada, Nata Jnanam Nata Shilpam, Nasa Vidya Nasa Kala, Nasa Yoko Nata Karma, Nadyas Minyan Nandrishyade.
Angigam Bhuvanam Yashya Vachigam Sarvamanmayam Agharyam Chandra Tarati Tamnumas Satvikam Shivam.
We start our first item for the evening with Pushpanjali. Pushpanjali has two words, Pushpa, which means flowers, and Anjali means showing respect. As the name goes, it's an offering to flowers to the Indian gods. It is usually the opening piece, the first dance in a Bharatanatyam performance. It is the salutation to the Lord of dance, Nataraja, the guru, the musicians and the audience. This particular piece is based on Ragam Nate, Talam Adi and it is choreographed by Raja
Kumbhe.
Thank you.
Very many languages, they chose to write all these kautums in Tamil, including the mention of Tamil Pan. Probably it was an attempt to carry the message to the layman and the vernacular of the area being Tamil. This kautum is Kubera, second ragam Malavashri and Talam Tishra Ekam.
Hey, hey. त्रिपताक हस्त विनियोग मकुटे वृक्ष भावेपी वज्रे तत्तरवासवे केतकी कुसुमे दीपे वह्नी ज्वाला विजुम्बने कपोते पत्रलेखायां पाणाथे परिवर्तने युज्यते त्रिपताकोऽयं तत्तत् कर्म प्रयोगके। अर्धपताक हस्त विनियोग पल्लवे पल्लके तीरे उभयोरतिवाचिके क्रकचे छूरिकायां च त्वचे गोपुरशृङ्गयो युज्यते अर्धपताकोऽयं तत्तत् कर्म प्रयोगके।
The next piece is Devi Niyeturai Kirtanam. It's in praise of the beautiful goddess Meenakshi Amman. The Sanchari Bhavam, that is the extended Abhinaya or expressions in this song, depicts the story of Meenakshi's descent on earth as a 5-year-old child after her parents' penance and grew up as an all-rounder in the field of education, arts and archery. She became a valorous princess and married Lord Sundareshwarar.
तेयुं तत् तेयुं ताम 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 तेयुं
beats of five takka takita takka takita takka takita takka takita takka takita
Tilana is the final item of a Bharatanatyam performance. Tilana gives scope for rhythmic variations and creates an atmosphere of final crescendo of pure nritya. In Tilana, the emphasis is on footwork. It is a vigorous number requiring exquisite execution of intricate steps, corvées. It's an attractive item with a number of alluring sculptures, poses, and variegated movements in geometric patterns designed in straight lines, triangles, diagonals, and even in semicircles. It is performed with grace and elegance. The characteristic finale of these corvées are in the form of arudis. This particular tilana is set in ragam vilahari and talam adi.
Thank you. శేషాద్రికొండ పై విలసిల్లు స్వామికి జయ మంగళం నిత్య శుభ మంగళం శేషాద్రికొండ పై విలసిల్లు స్వామికి జయ మంగళం నిత్య శుభ మంగళం